हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू हेल्थ म्यूजिक एंड फिटनेस चैनल। दिस इज ईसीजी व्लॉग नंबर 5। वी विल डिस्कस 2 or 3 ईसीजीज एंड दे आर पर्टेनिंग टू द प्रीवियस वीडियो विच वी प्लेड, दैट इज LVB, RBB, LAHB एंड LPFP। सो विल स्टार्ट राइट अवे। जस्ट टू गेट यू अक्वेंटेड, दिस लुक एट दिस रिदम, V1 एंड V6 लीड्स। देर इज अ टॉल आर इन V5 with the M shape, ST depression with concavity upwards and D wave inversion. The opposite of that is in V1, deep S wave, and both are broad, more than 3 small squares. So it's a LBB type of pattern. In RBB pattern, it will be opposite of it. There will be RS R' pattern in V1, V2, and a deep S in V5, V6, ST depression, concavity upwards, and D wave inversion. In LBB you will get a left axis deviation, in RBB you will get a right axis deviation. So this is about these two leads, and now we'll just go through one or two examples of LBB. Now spend some time and look at this ECG. Look at the calibration. The calibration is normal, 10 small squares height, flat plateau is a properly calibrated ECG. The QRS is broad. Then your mind should look for causes of broad QRS. Look in lead V1, V2, V5, V6. And if you look in lead V1, there is hardly any R wave. In fact, there is a small Q wave you can see. And here also there is slight nudge upwards, so maybe this is a RS pattern, and or there is no Q wave. Sometimes it is very difficult to comment whether there is a R wave, small R wave, or it's a Q wave, and the machine will interpret it as anteroceptal MI, old anteroceptal MI, because V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, and V3 till V4, the R waves are not there. Now look in V5, V6, there is a broad QRS, there is a R wave. It's not necessarily that every time you will see a M pattern. That's why in the teaching video I didn't comment on the M pattern, because most of the times you will not see the M pattern. In this ECG also you are not seeing the M pattern, but the QRS is broad, R is tall in V5, V6, and there is a deep S wave in V1, V2, and there is a left axis deviation. So this ECG shows a left bundle branch block. Now we'll discuss the second ECG. Look at the calibration, rate rhythm axis. So lead one is positive, AVF is also positive, and then you look at the axis. Now we'll discuss the second ECG. In this also you will see tall R waves in lead 1, in lead AVL and V5, V6, the left lateral oriented leads. They are showing tall R wave, broad QRS, ST depression with concavity upwards, and a T wave inversion. And the reciprocal of that you are seeing in V1, V2. There is a deep S in V1, V2. Mind you, sometimes in LBB you will see an upright T also. That is called concordant T wave. And that you will see if there is a left bundle branch block and the patient has developed acute myocardial infarction. So in OPD, when you're seeing a patient and you know his ECG, previous ECG, and next time he comes to you with chest pain, and you see the ECG looks normal. You say the T is upright, so there is no ischemia. But always compare with the previous ECG. If the previous ECG showed a T wave inversion, and in the same lead, in the fresh ECG, there is a upright T wave, that doesn't mean it is okay. It means the patient is infarcting and the axis is changing. So you have to keep this in mind. There is a Garbosa's criteria, and we'll discuss that in another video, as Garbosa criteria to diagnose acute myocardial infarction in the setting of LBB. Once we discuss acute myocardial infarction, we'll discuss Garbosa's criteria. So this ECG also shows predominantly left bundle branch block, and there are occasional ectopics also, ventricular ectopics. You can recognize them with the shape of the ectopic. It will be different from the regular complexes. Now we'll discuss right bundle branch block and its examples. Look in lead V1 and V6. So in right bundle branch block, the vector is changed. The left bundle branch is stimulating the right ventricle. So V1 is becoming more positive. The right oriented leads are becoming more positive. So there you will see a broad QRS and a RS R dash pattern in lead V1, ST depression with T wave inversion. And the ST depression is with concavity upwards. And in V6, you will see the opposite of it, a deep S wave in V6. Now you must be wondering why there is a RS R dash pattern. The first R wave is because of depolarization of the interventricular septum. And then after that, there is a broad QRS, the broadening of the QRS complex, and there is a second R wave that is called as R dash. And that is because of depolarization of the right ventricle via the left bundle branch. So we'll discuss one or two examples of right bundle branch also, block also. You see in this ECG, this is showing right bundle branch block. There is RS R dash pattern in V1, broad QRS, more than 3 small squares, ST depression with concavity upwards, and a inverter T wave. Now mind you, this T wave is slightly biphasic. That is also called as valence sign. We'll come to this signs in a separate video. This is valence sign, biphasic T wave in lead V1, V2, V3. It denotes high LAD block. So this is all about in this ECG. We'll see another example of right bundle branch block. This is another example of right bundle branch block. You see a RS R dash pattern in lead V1, V2 and a S wave in V5, V6. There should be no S wave in V5, V6, lead 2 because the vector is directed normally towards these leads. The current is not going back towards SA node again. So there should not be any S wave, but in this ECG you are seeing a S wave. So the vector is changed. It is directed towards the right ventricle. The left bundle branch is stimulating the right ventricle because the right bundle branch is blocked. And this is not a very nicely broad QRS. Sometimes you may call it incomplete right bundle branch block. Look at the axis. There is a tall R in lead 1 and in lead AVF. In lead AVF, it is negative. There is a S wave. So according to this, there is a left axis deviation. And you might be wondering that I had told you that there should be a right axis deviation. Always be subject to questioning and always question your findings. So right now suddenly I noticed that there is a left axis deviation, but there it is showing a right bundle branch block. Then you scan the ECG again. Now you are seeing a S wave in lead 2 and lead 3. So that is a left anterior hemi block also. And whenever there are left ventricular, left anterior hemi block, left posterior fascicular block, left bundle branch block, they are more powerful electrically. They will override the findings of the right bundle branch block. So ideally, there should have been a right axis deviation, but because there is a LAHP, so it is ECG showing a left axis deviation. So in short, this ECG shows a bifascicular block, which is right bundle branch block, and a LAHP. Another example of LAHP we'll discuss, and then we'll conclude this video. Again, look at the calibration, calculate the rate, rhythm, and axis. Always never bypass these steps, because like in the previous ECG, it was showing a right bundle branch block, but the axis was opposite to it. Now in this ECG, We'll look at the axis. Look in lead one, it is tall, so the axis is around 0 degree only. Look at the most isoelectric complex, 2 is isoelectric, 3 is not, 2 is isoelectric. So perpendicular to 90 degree to lead 2 is AVL. Look in AVL, so there is a tall R in AVL. The axis is minus 30 degree or beyond that. So then there is a left axis deviation, but the QRS duration is normal. It is not a left bundle branch block for sure. Now you think of other causes of left axis deviation with a normal QRS duration. That is left anterior hemi block. Look for deep S in 2-3, it is there. So it's a left axis deviation, LAD, LAHB, left anterior hemi block. There are many other findings in these previous ECGs and in this ECG. We are not going into the depth of those findings because those are myocardial infarction related findings, which we'll discuss later on. But just for your curiosity, you should see there is a inverted P wave in V1 which shows left atrial enlargement. There are Q waves from V1, V2, V3, V4, and there is slight coving. So this is a recent anteroseptal MI, and the R wave amplitude is very small in V5, and so it's almost anterior wall MI. And look in V6, there is a very tall R wave and there is ST depression, and this is left ventricular hypertrophy, and almost a strain pattern is developing. And also out here you will see a broad QRS complex with T wave inversion. This is a ventricular premature complex, VPC. And how you will differentiate between VPC and LBB? In LBB, there will be a P wave followed by a broad QRS. In VPC, there will be no P wave because the impulse is starting in the myocardium. And sometimes you will see a retrogradely conducted P wave. In that case, you will see a upright R in AVR. So this concludes the video. Thank you for watching. And please subscribe and tell your friends also to subscribe. And if you like, please comment, share, and hit the bell notification icon and spread the word around, and keep following and visiting the channel. And if you want me to cover a specific topic, please write in the comment box. I will try to make a video on that. Thank you.